Okay. You look good in purple.
I do. I feel vain.
I feel vain.
I'm vain.
Okay, so we were discussing the fact that one of our friends said that, well, there were bills that needed to be paid, but somebody's husband wanted to go get, like, a new pair of sunglasses that were probably going to eat up, like, several hundred dollars. Now, I get it. There's niceties in having nice things. I get it. Everybody, I mean, I carry a Patagonia bag, which was only $50, by the way, but I could have gone out and spent a lot more money on another bag. But I mean, why do people feel like, especially like people who don't make, well, I mean, this person we're talking about makes pretty decent money, but people, look, but if you really get down to it, unless you're making $200,000 to $300,000 a year, you're not going to be considered wealthy. So why would you go spend your hard-earned income on something with a name brand label on it when everything is literally made in China nowadays? Yep, you're right. Look at there. There's a train.
Let's go to China.
We're not going to China. So why would you spend your hard-earned money on something just because of the name brand when you don't have that much hard-earned money to go around? You know? Well,
here's what confuses me is how people who chase after that kind of thing and think that it's status.
And this is a generalization. This is not talking about the general parts. This is just a generalization.
Like, to me, it's a reflection of their own perspective and what they value. Like, obviously, if they're going to be spending $300 on a pair of sunglasses, they must think that if they see somebody else with that same
$300 pair of sunglasses.
That they think more of that person, and they think this is going to make the world think more of me.
So, yeah, okay.
Here's me. I'm just going to talk about me. And I don't want to make this seem like I'm better or conceited. This is just my opinion of things. Like, if I see someone that is painful, and you can tell because it is painful. It's painful for them and painful for me to witness it. If you see someone trying to wear the Patagonia, trying to wear the name brand sunglasses,
the Costa sunglasses,
I'm not thinking, oh,
and you know,
wow,
they don't make any money. You know they're not wealthy.
I'm not thinking that's alpha right there, or that's going to make him alpha. I'm thinking, God, that must be horrible having to spend that much
money. It must suck to be in debt.
It makes me nervous for them. It makes me sick. And that's just, I don't look at someone like that and want to chase that status. Maybe that's why I wear a dumpy polo that's like 5 or 6 years old.
Well, you just don't care.
I don't. No, I really don't.
I know you don't.
Like you say, people, I don't give a frick. I mean,
a frick.
That's really me. I don't chase after
you
status.
Don't feel like you have to impress
status.
Somebody based on that.
No, because I'm just awesome anyways.
You're just awesome anyways.
I don't have to buy, and it goes back to what we talk about so much is legitimacy. It's people who feel like they purchased
your legitimacy.
But the scary part about that is that it works both ways, is that people see other people with this purchased legitimacy, and they give them that legitimacy. You see what I'm saying?
Well, that's it's because the they—it's the same. It's because they're like-minded. They're like, oh, that person wears a Nike hat, and well, I wear a Nike hat too, and that's cool because we're bros.
Yeah, there's all sorts of ways that people perceive legitimacy, earn legitimacy. The trophy wife, what we're talking about, the name brand things. It's so skewed because it gets to the point of having to do everything to impress.
And women
somebody.
Do it too. They want the trophy husband. They want a husband who makes $150,000 a year and has a six-pack abs, and
so he can buy her the things that earns the legitimacy.
Well, yeah, like I know this one person who, like, she's married to this guy, and she, like, the guy works all the time, and he keeps her up, and she goes out, and she sleeps with everybody, but she stays at home. She doesn't want any kids. They're never gonna have any kids. And there's Brentug. And he doesn't know, or he doesn't care about the life she lives because she looks good, and he's purchased her, essentially. He's purchased her to look good because he makes money and he feels like he needs that. It doesn't matter that she doesn't love him, or that there was never any love there, or that there's no trust or care. All that really matters is that she looks good. He doesn't care that she's sleeping with everybody else because...
I mean, and some people, well, when it gets to that point, you know, they're just selfish. But I know this, at least vanity. One of the people I know that I'm referencing is not as a good person, really. They're just caught up in that impressment. And it's hard to be a guy. People don't realize...
it's hard to be a girl, too. It's hard to be a human in the societal norms that we have inflicted upon us today.
There is this whole...
It's because social... Hollywood, keeping up with the Joneses, it's all stupid. And you realize you've wasted your whole life trying to impress people who don't even give a shit about you. All they really give a shit about is themselves.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, that's all people care about is themselves. I am not going to Chinese. I was like, you might
as well.
As
bad as it gets to the point that people use you as a fashion accessory. They use your company.
He's crying because we're
they
not
use things. Your company to increase their legitimacy, and that's as far as it goes. And that's bad too. People are just bad, and there's cures, but
There's cures, but you gotta pay for them. You gonna pay for that cure?
And by humility.
But you know what? I'm glad. I'm glad for my cure. I'm glad for the humility. I'm glad for the knockdowns I've had in life. I'm glad for the failures. It's all been worth it to me. To not have to feel like I have to live some insecure life. Because now, you know what? I feel like I don't have to impress anybody except for myself. What I do for myself. I come in the other day to the nursing home and my Aunt Deb said, "Why are you so dressed up?" I said, "What do you mean?" She was like, "Well, you got on dress clothes." I said, "What's your point? Your makeup done? Your hair done?" I was like, because it makes me feel good about myself.
And that makes that's what people find attractive is they see it's not attractive to not even care about yourself, you know.
So somewhere in there's got to be a fine line between you have to do it for yourself. You can't do it to impress other people, or you're never going to win. You're always going to be unhappy. You're always going to be like spending your money and chasing that you don't need. For other people. If you get it to the point to where you're doing stuff because you literally want to do it for yourself, that's one thing. But if you're doing it for the impressment of other people, that's another thing. Although, sometimes those have to intersect. Like, I'm not going to be able to go to medical school and be some frumpy person. When you get out of medical school, you're going to be...
What I was thinking about before I lose it. It's hard to be a woman, I know, but it's really hard to be a guy, too. And I've just kind of removed myself from that race. But if you step into that arena and constantly compete to be the alpha male, it's a hard life. Bro judge. And that's where that shit comes in. The sunglasses, the name brands, the cars, the trophy wives. And that's hard. You lose yourself, you lose your soul. And then at the end of it, you realize that you have been trying to impress these people who have just been using you and your company, using you. Like, if you were to have lost everything.
They wouldn't want you anymore.
No, they would fall.
They're going to fall away.
Fall away.
If you went from riches to rags and everything you knew and everybody you knew only hung out with you because of your money, you would be left with nothing. You might as well just kill yourself because your life would be over then. The way you lived.
I read, the 48 Laws of Power. It reminds me of one of the things it says is to stay away from unsuccessful people. And stay away from them like a plague that would ruin your own success in life. And that's that.
Well, that kind of comes down to the company you keep. And even the Bible says that, though. I mean, on some level, it is true. The company you keep determines whether you're going to be successful in life or not. So anyways, this has turned into like a 9-minute, 34-second video already.
There's been some good points, though.
Some good points. Don't lose your soul trying to impress other people. It's not worth it.
Don't get bro judged. Don't worry about it.
And on that note, we're going to the gym.